Welcome to Daily Dose Radio, a 5-minute devotional podcast studying the Psalms verse by verse. Broadcast from the ever beautiful Sharonville, Ohio, on the sunny side of Cincinnati. Hey there, friends, welcome back to Daily Dose Radio here in the Bible Bistro. Well, this is the program that is packed with protein and probiotics. As a matter of fact, 9 out of 10 doctors say you ought to be listening to Daily Dose Radio. It's good for you. So today we are looking at Psalm 119, verses 82 and 83. As I said yesterday, this is an honest expression of the afflicted man. And you're going to say, I've been there. I've done that. I've said those words. Because, as I said, it's honest. And if we're all honest and we look at this section, 81 through 88, we're going to find things here that we've all said and all thought. Let me read for you today verses 82 and 83. Mine eyes fail for thy word, saying, when wilt thou comfort me? For I am become like a bottle in the smoke. Yet do I not forget thy statutes. 82, well, it's very telling, isn't it? So first thing we have here in 82 is failure. But it's not just any failure. It's specifically, my eyes fail. My eyes fail for thy word. Now, eyes failing for the word is just like the fainting for salvation that we had there in 81. They fail because he can't see the word. So he's looking for the word, but he can't find it. And so his eyes fail because there's no word around for him to find. So they fail for thy word, saying, when wilt thou comfort me? Now here, in the second part of 82, we have a very telling prayer, don't we? The first part, he's talking about the failing of his eyes for the word, this desire that he has to see the word. And then we have this honest cry of the heart that just sort of comes in here. When will you comfort me? Well, how's he going to get comforted? Well, apparently being able to see the word of God is going to comfort him. But there's something more happening, and we're going to find out what that more is in a moment. But this is the first piece or the first clue that we have in this particular section as to the trouble that he's having. And he prays this prayer, when will you comfort me? Now, I said, this is honest. Have you ever prayed this prayer? I'll admit that I have. I will admit that I've prayed, oh God, how long? How much longer do I have to put up with X, Y, or Z? Oh Lord, how long is it going to be before you comfort me in, you know, something, whatever it might be. I've prayed this prayer. I'm certain you have too. If you're honest, the psalmist gives us something here that is, it's a little uncomfortable perhaps because we say, well, how come we don't have a confident confession of faith here? Well, we're going to have that. Actually, in 83, in the B part of the verse, we have some confident expression of faith. But what's wrong with a little holy discouragement? And that's exactly what this is. He's doing what's right. He's fainting for salvation, hoping in the word. His eyes are failing for the word of God. He wants to know when's comfort going to come because he's definitely under affliction. I am like a bottle in the smoke, he says. Now we have this lovely little similitude here right in the middle of the whole thing, a bottle in the smoke. Now remember, the bottle that he's talking about is an animal hide bottle. It's supple and it expands, you know. Jesus talked about this, the new bottles, when you put new wine into new bottles, they're both preserved, the bottle and the wine. But if you put new wine into an old bottle, the skin will burst because it's not able to expand anymore. It's gotten old. Well, here, a bottle in the smoke, what happens to it? It dries out. It gets cured, just like a ham in the smoke. You know, if you put ham or some piece of meat in smoke, you're going to partly cure it and partly cook it. And so the bottle in the smoke is going to get the same treatment. But then he says, I don't forget your statutes. So even though he's like a bottle in the smoke, you know, and there's lots of other effects that smoke has on us and on things, he's referring to all of that. Here he says, even though that's happening to me, I don't forget your statutes. All right, join me again tomorrow. We'll go from this confident confession here in 83 and jump right into some more in 84 and 85 on Daily Dose Radio.
Thanks for listening to Daily Dose Radio.
I'm David Smith. The music today has been performed by the Bluegrass Experiment. Thanks again for listening. I'll see you next time on Daily Dose Radio.